Hello, and welcome back to Finnegan's Wake, the project where I, Jeff, read the book Finnegan's Wake to everybody out there on the internet, one page at a time, normally one page at a time, until Friday of this week, two pages at a time, one day at a time, until I get caught up. Finnegan's Wake is a book by James Joyce, published originally in 1939, although the version I am reading from does embody a number of corrections made by the author and implemented posthumously. But today we're on to page 122, and here we go. Ampersands under which we can glimpse at and feel for ourselves across all those rush years, the warm, soft, short pants in the quick scribbler. The vocative lapse from which it begins and the accusative hole in which it ends itself. The aphasia of that heroic agony of recalling a once-loved number leading slip by slipper to a general amnesia of misnomering one's own. Next, those R's all bellicle. The high priest's hieroglyph of Kettle Tom and Odd's Bones, wrested red-handedly from our hallowed rubric prayer for truce with booty, O Remus pro Romulo, and rudely from the fane's pinnacle tossed down by Porter to within an aim's ace of their quatrain of ruby jets among those who are without the temple nor since Rose Distillery burned have quaffed night's fire-filled cup, but jig-jog jug as day the dice-box throws, wang, loyal six I lead, at we're hearts blued, blast ye, and there she's for you, sir, wang her, the fine ooman, rouge to her lobster locks, the Rossi, wang, God and Omara has it, with his ruddy old villain Rufus, wait, wang, God, and you're another he hasn't, for there's my spoil five of Spud's trumps. Wang, whack on his pigs kings. Kisser for him, KM, Omara, where are you? Then, coming over to the left aisle corner down, the cruciform postscript from which three basia, or shorter and smaller, oscula, have been over-carefully scraped away, plainly inspiring the tenebrous tunk page of the Book of Kells, and then it need not be lost sight of that there are exactly three squads of candidates for the Crucian Rose awaiting their turn, in the marginal panels of Column Killer, chugged in their three ballot boxes, then set apart for such hanging committees, where two was enough for anyone, starting with old Matthew himself, as he with great distinction said just then, as since then people speaking have fallen into the custom, when speaking to a person, of saying two is company when the third person is the person darkly spoken of, and then that last labiolingual basium might be read as a salvium if whoever the embracer then was wrote with a tongue in his, or perhaps her, cheek, as the case may have been then, and the fatal droop-dwindled slope of the blamed scrawl, a sure sign of imperfectible moral blindness, the too-muchness, the far too many-ness. And that, gentle readers, was page 122 of Finnegan's Wake. That's all for today. We'll catch you the next time! Good night.